coming up now, we got a wonderful, wonderful singer singing a new song off of her new CD, Give Me Some Wheels. Please welcome Suzy Boggess.
Mama's crying in the kitchen. Even the dog can feel the chill. She lays her head down on the table next to a stack of unpaid bills. Daddy comes and puts his arms around her. He says, girl, your stocking's starting to run. Now it ain't never been easy, but ain't it always been fun, fun, fun. We fell in love and there's no way out. We fell in love and there's no way out. Sometimes you just gotta laugh. And hanging from a tree, kicking the tires on the T-bird. He says, T, you ain't gonna get the best of me, not this time. Mama comes dancing out the back door, snapping a dish towel in her hand. She says, don't you be wasting all that good energy. Don't you know I will love a sweaty man? Oh, man, oh.
We fell in love and there's no way out. We fell in love and there's no way out. Sometimes you just gotta laugh.
Lovely, just lovely.
I'm loving you.
No, I'm loving you.
Oh, I'm loving you more.
Yeah, what a great jacket.
Thank you.
It's actually like three great jackets, isn't it? There's one here, there's one there.
Well, it used to be, but I had all these old things made into something new.
Yeah, I love that tune. That's a good
one.
Thank
you. It's really fun. I'm glad to have it.
It's off of your new CD.
It's off my brand new CD called Give Me Some Wheels.
Give Me Some of Them Wheels.
Yes, and it's called No Way Out.
Yep. Okay, the last time I ran into you out in the real world, I saw you at CMAs and stuff.
Yeah.
You were shoveling sushi into your face.
Well, I wasn't.
Eating a lot of raw fish.
Yeah, I was. Yeah, I like sushi.
Yeah, you do. You didn't strike me as being the sushi kind of person.
Well, I was thinking about opening a place in Nashville, down on Music Row, and it would be called. It would be like a place where we could all go schmooze, right. And it would be Suzy Schmoozy Sushi.
Ooh, yeah. Man, that just
Sushi Boggess.
Just Sushi Boggess.
That's even better.
I
like this better.
Very nice.
Good.
Speaking of wheels and this infatuation you have with transportation,
yes.
this you're doing something that's really wonderful. And as a parent, I've got one of my children right over there, and I have two others. And you're doing something that is really, really wonderful with the seatbelt.
I'm the seatbelt lady.
You're the seatbelt lady, and it's great. You're saving people's lives with this thing.
Well, I hope so. I mean, I don't know everything about it, but I do know how to give out the right phone number for people to call and find out all the information, because we have so many new kinds of cars, and we got the bags and airbags and all that stuff, and different kinds of car seats and stuff. So I'm trying to help people get to know that, because I have friends that, you know, they don't know what to do. And I personally have always wanted to keep my kids in the back seat, but I only have one, but kid.
Can we show your little clip?
Oh, you have a PSA?
Yeah, right. We do. Can we roll that?
Great.
I have a son named Ben. He's my little boyfriend. He's everything to me, and I'd do absolutely anything for him. Can you imagine life without your child? You shouldn't have to. Every year on our highways, children die in traffic accidents because they aren't riding in a child's safety seat. This is Susie Boggess reminding you, before you start any trip, take just a few extra seconds. Make sure your child is safe and secure. Protect the one you love.
That's great. That's great. Okay, that's wonderful. When I was a kid, I didn't ever even think about it. I remember sitting in the back seat, man. Dad's flying down the interstate,
with
and I'm just like,
hey, back there, you.
I didn't worry about anything, you know, back then. I just watching Gunsmoke and Petticoat Junction and
Partridge Family.
No.
Yeah, that was
my favorite. You're a Partridge Family person.
Oh, Partridge Family, Brady Bunch. I was a big, big fan. I mean, I think I discovered
Susan
that I was...
Susan Day. Right. Whoa,
yeah, this is the Partridge Family hairdo. That's right. Yeah. I kind of got the whole look, the shoes and everything. But, you know, actually, I think I discovered that I was a woman watching...
Really?
Keep Partridge.
Yeah? David Cassidy.
David Cassidy.
Really?
I used to watch every day. I knew when he was having a bad hair day.
Hang on a second.
Oh, no.
We turn to the seas. We see Carson, Cash, Cassidy. Hold on a second here.
Okay. You think he's home? I think he's probably, like, on stage somewhere.
Have you ever talked to him?
No.
Hang on. You're about to. David. Gary Chapman.
Oh, God.
Yep.
How do I look?
Yeah. Like, would you do me a favor?
Okay.
Got a huge fan here that just wants to say hello. Can you do this for me?
Oh, God.
Are you busy? Okay. Do you mind if I put you on speakerphone? No, it's just a couple people. It's no big deal. Oh, okay. Hang on 1 second. David, are you there?
I'm here.
David Cassidy, ladies and gentlemen. It is. I'm telling you, it's him.
This is not David Cassidy. This is one of your
producers. It's David Cassidy.
Getting out of the shower here.
Oh!
No, man.
How are you?
I'm really good. How are you?
I'm great. I was listening to the song that you just did. It's fantastic.
Do you think I should remake I Think I Love You?
Do a remake of I Think I Love You? Well,
could you do a duet with me?
Yeah.
Why don't you sing it to her?
Yeah.
Would that put you over the top if you could do it?
Oh, man.
No, why don't you sing it to me?
Yeah, well, would I could.
Go on.
Well, oh, man, my heart is beating fast here. I'm going out tomorrow and get my bus painted just like the Partridge Family's bus.
Yeah, well, give me some wheels, you know?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I love that idea. Give me some wheels. It's an interesting idea. You could tour around in the Partridge Family bus with it and give me some wheels out.
Hey!
I like it. It's David Cassidy. Here, I'm going to let you talk to him because we got to run. David, thank you so much.
My pleasure.
Bye.
Okay.
Thank you.
God bless you. Take care of yourself.
Yeah, he's over there. David Cassidy, what do you want here? Coming up, we got another song from Clint Black, plus from the hit series.
Like conversation, avoiding the issue at hand. Then he made the coffee, and she did the dishes. They sat down at the table again. She waited a moment, hoping he would speak. speak first, though it never had happened before. He sat there in silence, expecting the worst, till she couldn't wait anymore. Just had to clear the air. He looked at her like she was speaking Chinese, with some of the letters left out. Try as he may, he just didn't know what she was talking about. Understand.